Welcome back, Masterclass members. In part 11 of our series on chronic adult and senior knee joint pain, we will continue discussing anatomy and its importance in accurately targeting pain generators and administering injections. This topic and anatomic study may be boring, but it is fundamental knowledge to make a target the pain generator and put the needle accurately. Chronic adult knee pain represents a significant market for pain interventionists. A large community-based survey has reported the prevalence of knee pain among people aged 40 to 80 years to be around 30%, with a higher prevalence demonstrated for certain occupational groups. The size of this market is influenced by people's expectations of pain relief from treatments. Patients who experience minimal pain relief from intra-articular steroid injections and do not anticipate further relief might not seek pain management doctors, believing the limited relief represents the full extent of injection interventions. However, discovering new, more effective treatments beyond conventional intra-articular injections could encourage more people to improve their pain management and seek doctors who provide advanced pain relief techniques. This topic's potential value is in the millions, which is why I am working diligently on weekends to prepare a lecture that offers insight into chronic adult knee pain. In this session, we will further explore the anatomy of the posterior knee. Join our masterclass membership today and unlock a treasure trove of knowledge. Benefit from twice-weekly videos, including inspiring lectures, clinical case discussions, and image interpretation insights. Elevate your skills and connect with like-minded doctors. Subscribe now for a brighter professional future. First, we will extend the basic concepts of the three layers of the medial capsula and supporting structures to the posterior knee joint. The first layer, or the superficial layer, consists of the crural fascia. This fascia extends from the fascia latae of the thigh and envelopes the entire lower extremity, covering the superficial muscles in the posterior knee, such as the gastrocnemius, anserinus muscle and tendon, and biceps femoris. The intermediate layer is primarily composed of the superficial portion of the medial collateral ligament or equivalent structures. In the medial knee, it includes the superficial MCR, anserinus tendon or fascia, and semimembranosus muscle. Anteriorly, it extends to the infrapatellar tendon, while laterally, it reaches the iliotibial tract and biceps femoris. So, this layer covers the deep fascia of the posterior muscles, such as the gastrocnemius, anserinus muscle and tendon, and biceps femoris. Before diving into the deep structures, let's discuss the deep layer, which blends with the intermediate layer in the posterior fossa. It follows a similar course as the intermediate layer in axial sectional images. The popliteal vessels, tibial nerve, and gastrocnemius muscle run over the deep layer of the posterior fossa. When the gastrocnemius muscle and tendon are removed, the deep layer is revealed, consisting of the posterior capsule and various ligamentous structures. We will further detail ligamentous structures such as the oblique popliteal ligament, fabulofibular ligament, and posterior semimembranosus complex. The oblique popliteal ligament, situated in the posterolateral corner of the knee, attaches proximally to the fibula, the meniscofemoral portion of the posterolateral joint capsule, and the plantaris muscle, and distally to the lateral aspect of the posterior cruciate ligament facet on the posterior part of the tibia. The posterior semimembranosus complex is an intricate structure with multiple expansions and ligaments, contributing to the complexity of the knee joint's anatomy, which is placed in the posterior medial aspect of the knee joint. Beneath the posterior oblique ligament and other ligamentous structures, you can observe diffuse fatty tissue, which I will explain further later. The popliteus muscle and tendon, as well as the popliteus tendon extension, are visible in this area. These structures might seem complicated, but they are expansions of the external capsule of the posterior joint. You will notice how the thin layer of these structures on MRI images can be. You don't need to remember each structure separately for injection therapy, but have a basic concept of the deep layer and components. Unlike the medial and lateral knee joint space, where the deeper layer represents the innermost part of the joint capsule, the posterior knee contains unique structures under the deeper layer. The first of these structures is the posterior cruciate ligament and meniscofemoral ligament. These ligaments are located deeper under the deep layer, distinguishing them from the structures found in the medial and lateral knee joint spaces. The second unique feature of the posterior knee is a fatty pad structure that fills the intervening space between the posterior ligament and the deep fascial layer. This fatty pad is sometimes referred to as the pericruciate fat. The line represents the blended structure of the intermediate and deeper layers in the knee joint. The posterior cruciate ligament and pericruciate fat complex is situated deep beneath the deep layer. The posterior cruciate ligament attaches to the medial femoral condyle's intercondylar notch, slightly anterior to the articular cartilage margin on the femur, and to the posterior part of the tibia within a depression called the PCL facet, situated between the lateral meniscus and the medial tibial spine. The anterior meniscofemoral ligament of Humphrey is not present in every individual. But when it does occur, it passes anterior to the posterior cruciate ligament as it courses from the lateral meniscus to the femur. The posterior meniscofemoral ligament of Risberg is a small fibrous band within the knee joint that connects the posterior horn of the lateral meniscus to the medial femoral condyle. It courses posterior to the posterior cruciate ligament as it runs from the lateral meniscus to the femur. The illustration demonstrates the relationship between the posterior cruciate ligament, posterior meniscofemoral ligament, and anterior meniscofemoral ligament within the knee joint. Bear in mind that the posterior cruciate ligament and meniscofemoral ligament are situated within the intra-articular but extra-synovial space of the knee joint. As a result, intra-articular injections may not reach these ligaments or other structures located between the PCL and the deeper layers of the posterior fossa unless the capsule or fatty tissue was destroyed. In a cross-sectional cadaver specimen of the femoral intercondylar area, the joint space is observed to be filled with joint fluid. In the cross-sectional image, the yellow line delineates the border of the posterior cruciate ligament and fatty tissue. This fatty tissue, which has no specific name, is commonly referred to as the posterior fat pad. It occupies and fills the space between the ligament and the deeper layer. Although it may appear tight in the sectional image, there is ample space for administering a drug in this area. The posterior fat pad is a frequent site for posterior knee injections, which can provide relief from pain arising from the posterior cruciate ligament and the posterior roots of the medial and lateral menisci. I will show several axial T2 weight images and sagittal proton images. Please draw the deep layer, posterior fat pad, and posterior cruciate ligament by yourselves. Let me draw the line. The yellow line is the deep layer. The white arrow indicates the posterior cruciate ligament. The yellow line is the deep layer. The white arrow indicates the posterior cruciate ligament. The yellow line is the deep layer. The white arrow indicates the posterior cruciate ligament. The yellow line is the deep layer. The white arrow indicates the posterior cruciate ligament. I will show a sequential sagittal proton image of the posterior fossa of the knee and structures moving from the medial to the lateral parasagittal side. Will you follow my trace of the deeper layer and posterior fat pad? What is your feeling about the structure of the MRI findings? While the deep layer consists of multiple fascia and ligaments and looks complex, it is a thin layer compared to the posterior fat pad. So you will not feel any resistance or provoke pain while you introduce the needle and pass the posterior capsule or deep layer. It is easy to reach the posterior fat pad space easily. But if you direct the needle to the posterior semimembranosus complex, you will encounter resistance and provoke severe pain. These sequential axial T2 weight images show destruction of the posterior fat pad in the severe posterior root tear and pain. It means if you put the needle in the fat pad in the severely destroyed case, your injection can deliver the drug into the joint space, the posterior fat pad, and the posterior cruciate ligament. There is one thing you should learn: while you approach your needle to the posterior fat pad, you have several structures to avoid puncture. These are the popliteal artery, vein, tibial nerve, and some superficial cutaneous nerves. Thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful, and I look forward to sharing more valuable content with you in our upcoming videos.